Hi everyone, welcome to the next video in the series where we'll be covering everything you need to know about IRL live streaming. In the last couple of videos, I showed you how to set up the streaming apps you need for your phone and home PC, and how to stream from one to the other using the best codec and protocol while on a local network. Today I'm going to show you how to do that when you're away from home, so you can do a proper IRL live stream. The approach you'll be taking is free, but involves things like port forwarding and firewall permissions. So if that sounds like a big no thanks, maybe consider this other way, link in the description. For everyone else, let's go over a few things that are vital for this kind of connection to work. We'll start with an example you should be familiar with, connecting to Wi-Fi. When you connect your phone to a Wi-Fi router for the first time, you normally search for the SSID of the router and then enter your password. In the background, the router confirms your details and assigns an ID to your phone so it can identify it from everything else connected to the Wi-Fi. The phone is now part of a local network, which is like a bubble where the internet from the outside world enters your home through the router, which it then distributes to your phone and other devices. Make sense? The same thing happened when you connected your home PC to the router using an Ethernet cable, although you get to bypass the whole SSID and password part. A computer that's connected directly to a router is pretty trustworthy, since you can actually see the cable with your own eyes from the home PC to the router. But the router has to remember which is which when it comes to your phone and the home PC. It does this using an ID system of sorts called IPv4 addresses. For our needs, we only care about the IP address of the home PC, which has the streaming software we want to broadcast to from our phone. We got the IP address of the home PC from OBS Studio in the last video, where it's known as a server IP, 192.168.119. Using this bit of information, we could broadcast a video from our phone to the home PC, but where does it go from there? That's where the server port comes in. Basically, a port can only be used by one desktop app at a time, and while OBS is open, the port number of 4455 is bound to OBS. In other words, by using a combination of server IP and server port, we know our broadcast from our phone is going to the correct PC and desktop app on the local network. All good? Extending this concept to a remote connection isn't too different from what I've just described, but there's a couple of barriers that can get in the way. Let's go over some of those now, starting with what happens when you turn off the Wi-Fi on your phone or when you're outside the range of your Wi-Fi router. Your internet access switches to a cellular connection from your mobile provider, so your phone is no longer within the same bubble or local network as the home PC. And because of this, the server IP and server port that worked before are no longer accessible. In order to connect to the home PC remotely, you have to go through the router first and have it redirect your connection to the home PC for you, which is called port forward. The first step is to get the external IP address of your home router, which you can do while you're still connected to the local network, preferably on the home PC. Perform a browser search for what is my IP address, and one of the first results should tell you what it is. If you've got a VPN, make sure it's turned off while performing the check, otherwise you'll get the VPN address instead of the external IP address for the router. Okay, open a plain text editor like Notepad or TextEdit, paste the result into your plain text editor, and rearrange them into this format. SRT colon double forward slash 180.149.231.164:4455. Remember, this is a dummy address for demonstration purposes only. You have to use the result from what is my IP address for your connection at home. Copy the SRT address and send it to your phone in whatever secure way works for you. Then grab your phone and open the IRL app from last time. Create a new connection and name it SRT Remote. Then paste the SRT address into the URL field, double check the SRT sender mode is set to caller, and then save. As you can see, the steps are almost the same as a local one, but you're connecting to the router instead of the home PC. Keep in mind you'll need both connections, SRT local for when you're at home connected to the Wi-Fi, and SRT remote for when you're outside the Wi-Fi range of the router, or when you're still at home and you've turned off the Wi-Fi on your phone for testing purposes. We'll be doing this later. SRT local won't work when you're away from home, and neither will SRT remote when you're connected to the home Wi-Fi. Your IRL app will tell you when you're connected to the wrong thing, so it gets easier with time, but it can be a little annoying having to switch back and forth. To my knowledge, there's no going around this unless you switch to an online service like Bellabox Cloud. More on that in another video. Anyway, you can try the new connection, but more than likely it won't work. And if by miracle it does, it's probably because you're still connected locally. Try turning off the Wi-Fi on your phone to see if you can still broadcast to OBS on the home PC, which is probably a big fat nope. And that's because you've still got more work to do. The next step is to go into the admin settings of your router to see if it has NAT, NAT forwarding, or port forwarding as an option. Perform a browser search for your router's manual where there should be a way to add a new port forwarding entry. All routers with port forwarding require at least the following fields: an IP address, the server IP in OBS, an external and internal port both set to the server port in OBS, and a transport protocol type for the IRL broadcast, which you can go with TCP, UDP, or all. You need the correct combination of all these things for your IRL broadcast to be successfully received by the PC or not. Let's go over that again. You start an IRL broadcast on your phone using a transport protocol of SRT, TCP, UDP to the router's external IP address 180.149.231.164, while also telling it that we want to use the port number of 4455. The router checks the details of the incoming internet traffic, can see the protocol type being received and port number as its intended destination. The details match for a computer on its local network going by the IPv4 address of 192.168.119 and forwards internet traffic to their computer and port number. The home PC receives the IRL broadcast in OBS and Bob's your uncle. Now, I don't blame you for thinking your job is done, but there's at least four other things that can break everything we've done so far. Firstly, enable WebSocket server should be checked or enabled in Tools WebSocket server settings. There might be a typo in the SRT connection for your phone. Double check the external IP address of your router and port number and that these match with what you're using. Also, you haven't changed the media source in OBS, so it's using the same SRT information from last time. This stays the same regardless of whether your phone is connected locally or remotely. The router's IP address may not be static. For this to work reliably, the router's external IP address cannot change. If it's dynamic, that means it'll keep changing, which could be every hour, every day, or whenever. That means you have to keep updating the connection info in your IRL app, which really isn't practical, especially if you're away from home. The easiest way to get around this is to ask your home internet provider if they can give you a static IP address. If that fails, you'll have to look into a service like NoIP who offer a free dynamic DNS you can use instead. I've covered NoIP in another video, so go check it out after this one. And another option is Bellabox Cloud, where you can bypass all this port forwarding stuff altogether. Your router may be assigning dynamic IP addresses to all the devices on your local network. This should be an easy fix in the admin settings of your router. Look for terms like DHCP, static, IP addresses, reservation, or reserved for more information. Hopefully that's enough to steer you in the right direction, as it's a whole other video on its own. You might have a VPN on your home PC, router, or both. Basically, you need a way to allow internet traffic through the VPN to your home PC. If there's a bypass option, use that. If your VPN has a dedicated IP address, that might work. Or at your own risk, you can always turn off your VPN while you're live streaming and turn it back on again when you're done. And finally, your firewall software may be blocking the IRL broadcast from your phone to your home PC. This too can be on your home PC, router, or both. Basically, it blocks what it thinks could be dodgy internet traffic to and from a desktop app, a range of port addresses, and protocol types. Usually all it takes is for you to add a firewall rule that states the OBS desktop app, the port number 4455, and the protocol you're using, TCP or UDP, are all okay for inbound and outbound traffic. If this won't work, you might have to turn off your firewall software as well. Consider all these changes carefully and whether it's a risk worth taking. Hopefully, you've got multiple levels of security, so when you turn one thing off, there's another thing to fall back on. That also won't block what we're trying to do. And one more non-sponsored plug for a service like Bellabox Cloud is that you're usually able to leave all your VPN and firewall software on. Because of the way it works, there's no need to turn them off. But there's a couple of really cool things I'm going to demonstrate in the future that will only work with this kind of connection we'll be trying to set up today. So keep that in mind. Anyway, if all goes to plan and assuming you can get past all of these barriers, you should be able to IRL broadcast from your phone to your home PC from outside your local network. You can test this while you're at home by turning off your phone's Wi-Fi and using the SRT remote connection we set up earlier. If it still won't work after you've tried everything else and you've double and triple checked all the things, you might have to go with a service like Bellabox Cloud. Honestly, if you've gotten this far and it's still a no-go, it'll save you a few two gray hairs. But if you're one of the lucky ones, we're missing one very important part of a remote connection, and that's disconnect protection. For now, what I recommend doing is adding a looping video under your media source, like in this clip here, because there's usually a few seconds of nothing before disconnect protection actually kicks in and auto switches OBS to a BRB scene. We'll be covering disconnect protection using loop SRT in this video right here. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments. Like and share the video if you found it helpful. Otherwise, I'll see you over there.